in Hindersfjall, Geralt and Yen learned that Ciri had returned to the Isles. She'd rejoined her friend, the Masked Mage. They had boarded a boat and sailed off in an unknown direction. The boat had returned, one passenger on board, a creature as mindless as it was hideous.
Oh! must be the key.
Integrity compromised.
Who's who among Kaveri sorcerers? Alchemy for Household Dilemmas, Volume 3. This isn't it. Gottfried's Omni-Opening Grimoire. This is it.
Commencing annihilation.
Applied Galomancy.
Wants to gas me.
Gotta keep looking. Looks like he's suffocated. Horrible way to die. Intersections and geomantic lines. Not what I'm looking for. Applied Golemancy. Gotta keep looking. probably greeted them too.
Find the tome.
What was that title again?
Gottfried's Omni-Opening Grimoire. It's a...
Gotcha. Be right back.
Find the tome.
This it?
It is indeed. Now, back away a bit. I must deactivate the barrier.
What by you, if it is Advigiat?
Isolation chamber open. Disturbing indications of freedom.
There, at last.
Looked easy.
The hardest part is yet to come. We must reach the heart of the tower and cast a deactivating spell. The tower will surely do everything in its power to stop us.
Give me a minute. Need to prepare.
Of course, but please do hurry. Ready? Can we go?
Lead the way.
We must go to the central chamber. Try to power down the security measures. The defensive regulatory magicon could react. Be on your guard.
Os by you, if it is Advigiat.
Intruder detected. Acute threat to control systems.
Gottfried's treaties proved highly useful. It's over. Had you not arrived, I'd still be in that cage, surely. It's a trifle, but take it, please. Proof of my gratitude.
Thanks. Though I'd be more than satisfied if you calmed that storm, then took this tower somewhere else.
Consider it done. And should you ever visit Kuvir, do stop by Popvanis. Aburagi, Baratheon.
Wait, what are you doing?
Not this way, the door!
Thank you. You're alive! And in one piece!
One soaking wet piece.
Will you teach me to fly?
Another time, maybe.
Never seen such marvels in me life. Boom, flash, tower disappeared, and you was falling from the sky. And the storm, gone in an instant.
Now, didn't I tell you? It's what a witcher we needed. Hey, can't do better than an expert. And expert work deserves a fitting reward.
Always knew Onskelligers were honest folk.
Hey, well, if you ever come through here again, stop in. You'll be welcomed with open arms.
Thanks. Farewell.
Wait, Witcher. Did you happen to see me brother in there? Burns his name. He went in with the druid and a few other lads.
I found your friends. All dead, unfortunately. Sorry.
Told him not to go. But he wanted glory.
Let's go home, Njal. No point standing here. Farewell, Witcher. Thanks again for helping.
Must be lying there still, ever than from the battle.
Greetings. If you're in need of a weapon, I'd be glad to forge something for you.
Let me have a look.
Thank you.
So long.
Gossip about your mom, Kate. Think it's true?
Triss could not help Geralt, yet she did direct him to Corinne Tilly, an Oneiromancer and an expert at finding the lost and the missing. Guided by Corinne Tilly, the Witcher had a dream. In it, Ciri and I, the bard Dandelion, were reunited. Geralt now knew that to find Ciri, he would first need to find his dear old friend.
Someone your own size.
The Merry Adventures of Muriel the Lovely Harlot, adorned with humorous engravings.
Interested in books? You don't look the scholar, but oh, we've ones with drawings as well.
Let's see these books of yours. Farewell. My manifesto must be it. There's a letter inside. Vampire's last likeness.
Oh,
On Hinderskjalf, Geralt and Yen learned that Ciri had returned to the Isles. She'd rejoined her friend, the Masked Mage. They had boarded a boat and sailed off in an unknown direction. The boat had returned, one passenger on board, a creature as mindless as it was hideous.
That's it, Roach.
What do you want?
I'm looking for Hammond.
What for?
Business.
He prays at the chapel on the hill this time of day. If it's slaves you're looking to buy, you'll have to wait till he's done.
He's praying? Wouldn't have thought him a God-fearing man from what I've heard about him.
Yet it's not something that would surprise any man who knows him.
Another snook. You know the drill.
Damn, you're ugly.
Thank you.
mistake.
I want it.
Gods of the sea, I've never begrudged you no gifts. Grant me another victory, so I can make you another offering of me loot.
Don't mind me.
Fuck, what now?
Heard you were in Carradine's band.
Fucking say what you want. Come on, spin it out, you arse-licking bastard.
I'm looking for Yad Carradine.
And just who the hell are you?
A friend of a friend. I'm looking for Carradine. Thought maybe we could make some sort of deal.
What? Our business robbing some Novigrad pricks the wrong way? Plowing dills. Come on, what are you waiting for? Kill the fucker!
Lost your nerve?
You're dead! Fucking die already!
Storm, damn it.
Triss could not help Geralt, yet she did direct him to Corinne Tilly, an Oneiromancer and an expert at finding the lost and the missing. Guided by Corinne Tilly, the Witcher had a dream. In it, Ciri and I, the bard Dandelion, were reunited. Geralt now knew that to find Ciri, he would first need to find his dear old friend.
Took you.
Pretty likely Carradine lives in Novigrad, and he never severed ties with Hammond. They're actually in business together.
Learned something, too. He trades in, live goods on the sly. Owns a ship called the Pearl of the Coast. Runs between here and Skellige. Changed his name, too, to Roland Truger, who officially is a respected Novigrad trader and philanthropist. Has a residence in Gildorf.
Anything on Selyse?
Well, didn't have you there to stand up for her.
All right, let's pay Carradine a visit.
Think I know how to get in. Got a plan.
If your plan doesn't include dealing with an escort of guardsmen, best revise it. Calm now. Let them start it.
You're expected. Come in.
Make yourselves at home.
He's a witcher.
Very true. Allow me to introduce my wife, Letitia, and my two little tots. You know who I am, and I've heard of you. You've been asking many questions about me. That always draws my attention.
What school do you come out of?
That of the cat. So few of us left.
Understand a witcher becoming a hired assassin, but a merchant?
Why ever not? Not one among us doesn't dream of changing our life. I simply did not stop at dreaming. They say no witcher has ever died in his bed. I aim to be the first.
Remains to be seen.
Witchers can't have children.
But they can have wards, or take in a woman along with her children, embrace them as their own.
My friend needs to talk to you.
Lads, take the children and Letitia and leave us. Our guests wish to speak to me. I'm all ears.
Talk to him, Geralt. If I do, first word he says to me, I'll lose it and throttle the fucker.
Your wife know who you were?
We are thoroughly honest with one another, harbor no secrets. She prays for me each day. You know what? I think it's working.
Fucking hell.
Relax, Lambert.
I confessed all just before we pledged to marry one another. Began a new life that day, with a clean slate.
Nice place you got.
As it turned out, I've a flair for enterprise. Now I've coin enough to provide my family with the finer things in life.
With some left over for philanthropy.
Miss Marabella's Institute does not scorn small donations. Neither does the city's Widows and Orphans Relief Fund, amongst others.
Remember Aiden? A witcher. Murdered in Elander. Guessing the killers were paid well.
I remember him as I remember all the others, with the deepest regret. Yet Aiden was different in a way. Contrary to rumor, we did not set out to kill him. We were forced to when he attacked us.
What's your version of this story?
Aiden had accepted a contract to lift the curse from the Duke's daughter. He took the coin, bungled the job, then left once the girl passed on.
You lie.
We were not to kill him. We were debt collectors. He'd spent the coin already, so we demanded his swords. When he refused, tempers flared. Vienne, positioned as a sniper, lost her nerve. Hit Aiden square in the eye. Later, she devised her own version of the story. To silence her guilt, I expect.
I've heard enough.
What now?
You've changed. You have.
Forgiveness. It's my sole aim now.
You're buying this bullshit? Bastard's lying his ass off.
Leave him. Let's go.
You off your fucking nut?
Lambert, this is one of those situations when you have to realize you're pissed as hell, rein it in, and trust your cool-headed friend. Let's go.
For fuck's sake, Geralt. Don't know that I'll be able to forgive you.
I said let's go. You can always come back.
Thank you.
Explain yourself.
Don't intend to. Just felt Carradine didn't deserve to be murdered in cold blood. If you feel otherwise, you can always go back. Without me.
I feel like beating the shit out of you. See you later. Someday.
So long, Lambert.
Welcome, what can I get the honourable gentleman? New Poulains, perchance? I've not got a true pair, but they'll be the same size.
Fine. Show me what you got.
So, what don't I got? Something for everyone, seek and you shall find. Cheap, too. Come again. Cheap as it gets, right here.
When I grow up.
I trafted a woman once, long ago. I was willing to give me right hand.
Show us what you bring in this.
Fell, Geralt and Yen learned that Ciri had returned to the Isles. She'd rejoined her friend, the Masked Mage. They had boarded a boat and sailed off in an unknown direction. The boat had returned, one passenger on board, a creature as mindless as it was hideous.
Hurt.
Adventure seek, you just piss
and
into the wind.
Supper knives are good for picking your teeth.
And for some trotters, eh?
tell you!
Triss could not help Geralt, yet she did direct him to Corinne Tilly, an Oneiromancer and an expert at finding the lost and the missing. Guided by Corinne Tilly, the Witcher had a dream. In it, Ciri and I, the bard Dandelion, were reunited. Geralt now knew that to find Ciri, he would first need to find his dear old friend.
Thank you.
What say you we are over to a brothel, is it?
I ask for fresh fish. What's this?
Witcher, sir! Help a woman in need!
Brother! Sister!
Yablets up to the latest fashion! Get them here and down here!
State your origin.
Valen. War's on there, sir.
Valen's a high witchcraft.
Wonderful.
One day, a mother found her infant dying at her side. Spared Richter.
And her lad deals fist tech.
You'll not find much to do in Novigrad.
You are the famed Geralt of Rivia, are you not?
Strength for anything.
Kill one more beast, they'll give you the keys to the city.
Elven blood, eh?
The hell in his eye. Ought to use it.
Ugh!
Like that silk.
Thank you. This is not the end!
Send this.
bonus for working in piss poor.
That's it, Roach. Hey-ya! Slower.
But don't object to your white mouth.
That's the charge. Where's the tool?
Kiss by ourselves.
Come inside.
Shrimps will grow.
You're back. So, got the acid?
Mm-hmm. Use it carefully. It's about as caustic as things come.
I know. It's burned many a man where I come from. Armor's ready. Now for the last touch. We'll soon see who's better, Fergus or me. Geralt, it's done.
Looks very professional.
Welcome, General. Armor's all ready. Came out splendid, if I do say so myself.
Rather coarse. I trust the appearance does not reflect the quality.
General, I've also made a suit, if you please.
What is the meaning of this?
Exactly what it looks like. Yoanna crafted a suit of armor for you, General, to prove she's the superior armorer.
For God's sake, Yoanna! What do you think you're doing?
Temeria remains a wild land, it seems. Insubordination of this kind is not something we Nilfgaardians allow.
If I may, General, I am Fergus's subordinate in appearance alone. It's what we agreed, as few would ever believe a woman to be a better armorer than a dwarf.
You are right. I, for one, do not think it possible. But you are confident in your abilities. Let us put them to the test. Not on dummies. In live combat. Oh, quite a crowd.
You there. Put on this armor.
I'm just here to show me yours.
Mine is not a request.
General, I crafted this armor for a man. It can't fit me properly.
Then find another to wear it.
Geralt, will you help?
Fine. Hope I won't regret this.
Don your armor, both. I will await outside.
Bloody hell. I just came here to show me yours. I think I got scabies.
Ah! Does this look to you like armor that stops bolts? Compensate the man. Now, let us see what this other suit is worth.
Oh!
Iv?
Aye, but these armor's rubbish.
Stan, I wish to see the armor.
Not even a dent.
I am not easily impressed, but I must admit you have succeeded, my dear. Where to, dwarf? You must hear this. The forge is now Miss Ioana's. She will also assume all Nilfgaardian army requisitions. Is that clear?
Aye, as day.
Your pay for the armor. I will send a man to collect it.
I'll be going too, methinks. Just get my things.
Wait. We needn't part ways, Fergus. You've been a good helper. We could go on that way. But without the lie.
We did make quite the pair.
Well then, go stoke the fire. We've got a customer. He needs armor fit for a witcher. You weren't certain the armor would protect you. Admit it.
Master craftsmanship's something I trust in, something I strive for myself. Wouldn't have asked for legendary tools from Undvik and Archgriffin Acid if you didn't know what you were doing.
Thank you for trusting me. Give us a few days and your armor will be ready. Come on, let me help you get out of that. Geralt, good of you to come by. What can I do for you?
Need some armor made. Witcher's armor.
Interesting lilt in your voice. You originally from Skellige?
Ardskellig. Spent my whole childhood in Holmstein.
Why'd you leave?
Always had a liking for the smithy. I'd sit there all day taking things in. The heat of the furnace, the smell of the hot steel, the pounding hammers. At 17 winters, my dad told me he could teach me no more. Sent me out there into the world, bid me to hone my craft. A few years on, I had my master crafting papers. Then the war broke out and I landed here.
Take care now.